While studying the solar system, we observed that there are two celestial bodies, that is the sun and the moon, which affect us much. And during day hours, this is the star sun, that is the king of day. And during night, it is the moon, that is our satellite, and that reflects insolational light received from the sun to the earth, and that's why moon is called queen of night. And these two, king and queen, help us to calculate the time, and that's why let us study the time calculation on the basis of the sun. In this we will study solar day, solar month, solar year. And then, on the basis of moon, we will study lunar day, lunar month, lunar year. Now, let us learn how, on the basis of the sun, we, people on the earth, decide time. Now, first is solar day of 24 hours duration. Why and how? Now, let us try to understand. This is our earth. Sun is in this side. And earth's one point is here, suppose this point, this dark point is here, and here sun. This point promises the sun that, O God sun, you are stationary here, and I promise that I will be coming back here during 24 hours, because this point will complete one rotation and reach here. And this duration is 24 hours. That's why it is called simply a solar day. One thing to be noted in mind is the sun rays are vertical at a moment on only this point. It is not possible that sun rays are vertical on the entire globe. And the point where sun rays are vertical is called subsolar point. This subsolar point makes a complete rotation during 24 hours. To the north, the insolation will be slanting. Sun rays will be slanting. Likewise to the south, east and west. So, the duration of subsolar point in one rotation is called solar day. Now, solar month duration is of 28 days, 29 days, 30 days, 31 days. What is solar month? Solar month means this earth has to complete one revolution around the sun in 12 months. And if you take sun as a center, surrounding it, there are 360 degree angle. And if you divide it by 12, 30 degree angle. On the basis of 30 degree angle sectors, there are 12 sectors around the sun. And those are the 12 constellations, Rasi. And in one constellation, this earth will remain for a month. So month is decided on the basis of the 12 sectors. So month duration is sometimes 28 days, 29, 30, 31. It is very common thing. Everybody knows it. Now, 12 solar months will become one complete revolution of the earth around the sun. And that's why it is called solar year. After solar day, this is solar month, then now solar year. It is also called common year, the duration of which is 365 days, means 12 solar months. As we have discussed that around the sun, There are 12 sectors, 12 constellations, each called 1 month. So 12 month is 1 solar year. Remember that this calculation is based on the axial and orbital relationship between the sun and the earth. Now is sidereal day. The duration of sidereal day is 23 hours, 56 minutes, 48 seconds. What is this? Once we had studied that solar day duration is of 24 hours. Now sidereal day duration is only 23 hours, 56 minutes. Now let us try to understand it that suppose here is the sun and this earth is making one rotation during 24 hours. That's why it is solar day. But now what is sidereal day? You take that this point of the earth means subsolar point has promised the sun that I promise that I will come here during 24 hours. And according to its promise, it will start one to complete one rotation in 24 hours. But now you answer, during this 24 hour weather, this earth will remain stationary on its orbit or it will also. Now you imagine whether this point will complete one rotation during that period, whether this earth will remain stationary on its orbit or this earth will move ahead on its orbit. Certainly, answer is clear. Earth cannot remain stationary on its orbit. It will move ahead. How much? Let us calculate it. During 24 hours, by the time this point will be reaching here. And 24 hours means one day. This earth has to complete one revolution around the sun in 365 days. And around the sun, there are 360 degrees angle. So, on an average, in one day, Earth will move on its orbit by 1 degree. It means by the time this subsolar point will reach here in 24 hours, this Earth will move on its orbit by 1 degree. 1 degree means a long distance. And orbit of the Earth around the sun is elliptical. That's why this Earth will not go straight, rather it will be turning on its orbit. That's why this subsolar point will reach here again during 23 hours, 56 minutes and 48 seconds. And that's why this is called sidereal day. Now there is one question that whether 24 hours duration is true or 23 hours 15 minutes, because both are calculated on the basis of the sun. But in second one, the movement or motion of the earth on its orbit has also been taken into account. So, answer is very much clear that this is correct. But this correct thing is set in our watches, or this 24 hour is set in our watches. So, for generalization and for our happy time calculation, easy time calculation, this 24 hour is set in our watches, not this, because it may create a number of problems. But this is reality, and this 4 or 3.5 minute time is saved, and this saved time is here. This is a sidereal year, Common year was of 365 days. In sidereal year, this time saved is 6 hours 9 minute 54 second. That's why sidereal year duration is of 306 days and a quarter day, or more than that are 6 hours. And now sidereal year is also termed tropical year. Now per year, quarter of day is in surplus. That's why there is one leap year, and in leap year, 6 hours multiplied by 4 becomes 24 hours, and this 24 hour is added in leap year. That's why leap year duration is 366 days. One day it has extra. In which month it will be added, the month which is of minimum day length will get it. And that's why here in leap year, the duration of February is 29 days. One thing noteworthy is that this leap year is divisible by 4. If it is divisible by 4, then it is leap year. But century year, which is divisible by 4, is not a leap year. Rather, if it is divisible by 400, only then it will be leap year. Means, suppose 1600 AD was divisible by 400, that was leap year. 1700 AD was not a leap year. 1800, 1900 AD were not leap years, because those were not divisible by 400. But 2000 was divisible by 400, that's why it was taken as a leap year, but a special leap year. That leap year was not of 29 days, and that's why there was a problem in setting the calendar. Most of the astronomers took this 9 minute and 54 second time in consideration, and on the basis of this time, they decided that in real calculation, February of 2000 should be of 30 days. Generally, February is of 28 days, but in leap years, February is of 29 days. But in century, which is divisible by 400, leap year is of 30 days. But this problem was anyhow solved by the International Forum for Calendar Setting. And that time it was decided that let one day be left. And that's why in 2000 also February was of 29 days. So this is the calculation of day on the basis of the sun, wherein solar day and sidereal day are important, and they pay ground for the calculation of year. Now I think you understand that what is day, what is month, and what is year. And these are purely geographical. These depend on the relationship between the earth and the sun, and on the basis of their axial and orbital motion, these are being calculated. First is lunar day. The duration of lunar day is 24 hours and 50 minutes. How it is calculated? Let us understand it. This is the earth, and here is sun, and this is the moon. And now lunar day is calculated on the basis of the moon position and relationship of the earth and the moon. Now take that subsolar point. Actually, this is not a subsolar point at present, but if both are on a new moon linear position, it is subsolar point. Now this subsolar point promises the moon that I am going to make one complete rotation, and I promise that I will be reaching here within 24 hours. And moon, this is my promise. I will reach within 24 hours, and I request you to stay here. How is it possible? By the time this point will complete one rotation and reach here, that will take 24 hours. And moon will not stay on its orbit. Moon has to also travel, journey on its orbit. In how many days? In 29 and a half days. Take it generally 30 days. In 30 days, this moon has to complete one orbital motion. In 30 days, how many degrees? 360 degrees. If you divide 360 by 30, what angle you will get? 12 degrees. It means this moon, by the time this point will reach here, this moon will move on its orbit by 12 degrees. That's why moon position will be here. And when this point, according to its promise, will reach here, this point will not get moon in front. That's why this point in search of this moon will have to move 12 degrees. 1 degree in latitude we will learn, 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. 12 degree is equal to 48 minutes. By the time this will travel 12 degree, moon will move ahead. And that's why just to reach just in front of this moon, this point will have to travel 2 minutes more. That's why 48 plus 2 is equal to 50 minutes. This is the reason that one lunar day duration is 24 hours and 50 minutes. And now next is lunar month or synodic month, and duration of this is 29 days, 12 hours, 44 minutes. And it is actually axial movement, one point, and it looks contradictory that from one new moon to the other new moon. But now let us understand lunar month. Lunar day we have studied. Now lunar month means this moon will start journey from this new moon position, because this is the earth, moon, sun this side, and it will complete one revolution in 29 and half days. We have also studied that during this period, this moon will complete one rotation on its axis also. That's why the axial rotation is written here. Duration 29 and half days nearly. And this will be called lunar month. Lunar day was calculated on the earth on the basis of the moon. But lunar month is calculated on the basis of axial. This is also orbital. Don't be confused, because the axial and orbital duration of the moon are the same. But here is written axial, means one axial duration is called one lunar month. Now, after lunar month comes this lunar year. Lunar year means 12 lunar month. One lunar month duration is 29 and a half days. This one, 29 and a half days. And during this period, Earth moves on its orbit also. And by the time, during 365 days, this Earth will move around the sun, and there are 360 degrees around the sun divided in 12 sectors. That's why this earth will remain in one sector, that is one constellation, that is one rasi, for a month. And during that period, this moon revolves around the earth, one lunar month. Now this way, one question is there, that earth is revolving around the sun. It is correct. Second question is, point is, moon is revolving around the earth. This is also correct. But third one is, moon is revolving around the sun. Whether this is correct or not, this is also correct. How? Moon revolving round the earth is revolving round the sun. It means by the time this earth will make one revolution around the sun, this moon will make 12 revolutions around the earth. That's why these are called lunar month, 12 lunar month. And one lunar month duration was 29.5 days. So if you multiply it by 12, because there are 12 lunar months, the answer will be 354 days. Now you make it important that lunar year consists of 354 days, while the solar year or common year consisted of 365 days. So there is difference of 11 days. If you subtract this 354 from 365, there will be 11 days difference or saving. This we will calculate here, and that will be intercalation. But before this calculation, let us understand one more point, that is sidereal month. Sidereal month duration is of 27 days, 7 hours, 43 minutes, 11.5 seconds. And this is here written orbital movement. This was axial movement, this is orbital movement. You should not be confused in axial and orbital, because in both, time is the same. And that's why we, from the earth, can see only the same part, 50% part of the moon from the earth. Now, what is sidereal month? 27 days and 7 hours and some minute. Now, let us try to understand it. Suppose, here, this is the earth, this is the moon, and sun is in this side. And moon promises the earth that, earth, you remain here, and I promise that within 29.5 days, I will be completing one revolution around you and reaching here. And according to promise, the moon will start revolving round the earth. This has started. But now you decide whether earth will remain stationary on its orbit or it will have orbital motion. Answer is very much clear. According to astronomical principle, no celestial body can stay. Both, all the celestial bodies have axial and orbital motion to keep astronomical balance. That's why when this moon will start from here just to complete one revolution in 29.5 days, around 30 days. For 30 days, this earth will not stay here. It will move on its orbit around the sun. How much? It is very simple calculation. Because sun is here, earth is making one complete revolution around the sun, 360 degree angle, is covered by the earth. In how much duration? 365 days. It means per day nearly 1 degree. Now, moon will take 29 and a half days in one revolution. 29 and a half days. It means per day earth will travel by 1 degree. In 29 and a half days, take it 30. Then this earth will travel by 30 degree. One question arises, had this earth been stationary on its orbit, the moon might have revolved around the earth and in elliptical path, and there might have been perigee and apogee. But now imagine the orbital path of the moon had earth been stationary on its orbit. But reality is that earth is not stationary on its orbit. That's why as the moon will start its orbital journey, the earth will move on its orbit. That's why orbital direction of the moon, or say the orbital plane, or say the orbital ellipse, it is elliptical path, the orbital ellipse will not be normal. It will be distorted, because this moon, when earth will move this side, this moon is bound with the gravitation of the earth, and that's why it will cut short, and this way it will reach here. So had earth been stationary on its orbit, moon might have taken 29 and a half days. But because earth is moving on its orbit, that's why moon's path will become short, and in spite of 29 and a half days, moon will take only 27 days, 7 hours, 43 minutes, 11.5 seconds. This is the sidereal month. It means lunar month and sidereal month are different things. And this is the reality. Because in it, the earth has not been considered stationary on its orbit, rather moving on its orbit. So this is with reference to the orbital motion of moon and the earth. Now let us try to understand what is intercalation, what is intercalary month. Here we have studied that on the basis of the sun, one solar year is of 365 days. On the basis of moon, one lunar year is of 354 days. Thus, according to this calendar, lunar calendar, 11 days remain extra, means 365 year and 354, 11 days extra per year. And after 3 years, 11 multiplied by 3 is equal to 33 days. These 33 days are saved and become surplus. That's why in this calculation, there is no consideration of these 33 days. But according to lunar calendar, this is taken into account, and this one month is made surplus. That in English is called intercalary month, and in Hindi malmas. After every 3 years, there is one month malmas that is extra. Malmas means the saved material from all the month, and the things, good things, were accepted by all the gods, while the rejected things were accepted by Lord Shiva. That's why Lord Shiva is called not only Dev, rather Mahadev. So in this malmas, in India, we worship Lord Shiva, and that month is offered devoted to Lord Shiva. We have studied that the duration of one lunar year is of 354 days. It is shorter than the solar year duration. Why? Because you have seen that moon, along with revolving around the earth, also revolves around the sun. How? With this? How? With which figure? Suppose this is the sun and earth is revolving around the sun and moon is revolving around the earth, at the same time revolving around the sun. And this way, moon's every orbit around the earth becomes shorter. That's why these months are of shorter duration, and year also falls short by 11 days. And this in India is called Jalebyakar path, Jalebyakar orbit, like jalebi. Time on the earth is calculated on the basis of the sun and the moon, but some sambats or time is calculated or fixed on the basis of some great personalities, and those are called sambat. Now let us try to see one list of important sambat. Vikram Sambat started 57 BC, and this is zero. Christian era started from here on the name of Christ, Jesus Christ. In Christian means before it, it is BC, before Christ, and after it, it is AD, Anno Domini. In 78 AD, it was Shak Sambat. In 248 and 249 AD, it was Kalchuri Sambat. In 319 AD, it was Gupta Sambat. Again in 319 AD, it was Ballabhi Sambat. In 606 AD, it was Harsh Sambat. In 622 AD, it was Hijri Sambat. So this way, you should keep this data in mind, because one time there was a question that Pulkesin's first Badami inscription was inscribed there, that it was Shak 465, means this was Shak Sambat from here 465. But it was expected that now you calculate it in Vikram Sambat. So if it is considered zero, then 465 years will be somewhere here, and then to convert it into Vikram Sambat, this time will be added with 78 and with 57. Means to convert this Shak Sambat, you will have to convert, you have to add that value and 78 and 57. That's why answer was 601. So this is a chronology, this is history, but geography is both spatial science and temporal science. That's why this you should keep in mind, because sometimes calculations are asked in examinations.